IPL stands for intense pulse light, and what that means is it's utilizing the full visible spectrum. So really anything that we're using in the cosmetic industry, and I say that not meaning Botox or filler, but think of lasers and ultrasound and radio frequency and also IPL, is part of the EM spectrum. And there's many things part of the EM spectrum. Really anything that we use around us, our cell phones, microwaves, x-rays, UV, so the sun, that's all part of the EM spectrum. So IPL, intense pulse light, is part of the visible spectrum. And the visible spectrum is what's giving us all the colors that we see around us, the color of the rainbow. So we're able to take that visible spectrum and put it into a handpiece. A lot of people will know that as a laser, because that's the term that we usually know, but it is different than a laser. Reason being is that we utilize many wavelengths where a laser only uses one. So the beauty of an IPL, and it will never go anywhere within the industry, it will always be a very popular treatment, is that it can treat so much. So a laser, because it only uses one wavelength, it may only be able to target one, two, maybe three chromophores. So what a chromophore is, it's a light sensitive molecule. So anything light based, a laser, IPL, it's light, it needs to be attracted to something that is light sensitive. So things that are light sensitive are going to be hyperpigmentation, hemoglobin, which is found in our blood cells, so anything that could be related to vascular, acne. So the reason why we're able to treat acne is there's porphyrin. So I'm sure you guys have heard of P. acne bacteria. That's what puts the P in P. acne bacteria. It's called porphyrin. And porphyrin is highly light sensitive, and it's found in P. acne bacteria. Also water. Water is highly light sensitive, so the IPL naturally wants to be drawn to our skin. So we're able to use many wavelengths in the IPL. So everything that I just mentioned, it's attracted to. Where a laser only being one wavelength, we're a little bit more limited there, where it may only be able to target water and blood, or blood and pigment. So we're able to treat a lot with an IPL.